So in today's class, we'll be studying about the significance of the inclination of the Earth's axis. So the Earth's axis is actually an imaginary line on which the Earth is believed to be rotating. So in this diagram over here, you can see that the two ends of the axis are the North Pole and the South Pole. Now the axis is not a straight line, but it is inclined. As you can see, it makes an angle of 23.5 degrees to the vertical. This vertical is actually the vertical line from the Earth's orbital plane, and the orbital plane is, you know, what is orbit? Orbit is the path on which the Earth is believed to be revolving around the Sun. So with the plane of the Earth's orbit, the axis makes an angle of 66.5 degrees. So this inclination of the Earth's axis has a significance, has a great importance in bringing about seasonal changes on the surface of the Earth, and we'll be studying about this today. Okay, if the Earth's axis was not tilted, but if it was vertical, then there would be no seasons on Earth throughout the year. As we have seasonal changes, this would not have happened on Earth. So all the places on Earth would have had 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night if the Earth's axis was not inclined. Okay children, now I'm going to explain about the impact of vertical axis on the length of the day and night. So here, let us say if the axis of the Earth was vertical, then children, this place L located at equator would be at position L1 after exactly 12 hours. So the distance of OL and OL1 is almost equal. So the length of the day and the length of the night would be same. It would be the same in all places if you see. So if the Earth's axis was straight and not tilted, the length of the day and night would be equal all over the Earth. Okay children, now let us say, which is actually a reality, the Earth's axis is tilted. Alright, so the Earth's axis is tilted. It makes an angle of 66.5 degrees with the orbital plane and 23.5 degrees with the vertical. So in this position, if you see, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the Sun, as you can see this part, and the southern hemisphere is tilted away from the Sun. So over here in this diagram, to make things very clear over here, you will see that as we move from the equator towards the poles, the length of the day goes on increasing. And as we move from the equator towards the South Pole, you will see that beyond the Antarctic Circle, this particular area is in total darkness. So actually, to make things clear, here in this diagram you can see this part of the Earth is facing the Sun. Alright, so it is experiencing total light. And this part is facing away from the Sun, so it has darkness. So at the equator, the place C would be at C1 after 12 hours, because distance of CO is equal to CO1. So the length of the day and night is equal, and you all know that at the equator there are 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night throughout the year. Now when we come to Tropic of Cancer, because the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the Sun, so you can relate it to the fact that in India also, we are also living in the northern hemisphere. During the summer season, which we are experiencing now, you can see that the days are longer and the nights are shorter. As you can see, the Sun rises early but it sets late. Alright, similarly, the nights are much more shorter. Alright, so over here if you see, place B will be at position B dash after 12 hours, but the distance BX is greater than B1X. So the days over here are longer than the nights. Alright, in simplest terms. Then if you see this place A, you all must have studied in your lower classes that during summer in the North Polar regions, there's 24 hours of light for 6 months. So over here there's continuous daylight. All right. So at the Arctic Circle, place A will be at position A dash after 12 hours, but AA dash remains in continuous light in summer. So there's 24 hours light for 6 months in the North Polar region. Now you come to the Southern Hemisphere. Over here in the Southern Hemisphere, if you see, because it is tilted away from the sun, so what happens is that over here, as we start moving towards the South Pole, the length of the day goes on decreasing. I hope it is clear. I'll explain again with the help of another example. Children, in this below this diagram in your textbook, you will see a lot of written matter is there. I have explained. You don't have to mug up these parts. All right. And at the end of this class, I'll give you a short note on the inclined axis, which you must note down in your copies.